What about some that are more recent in our history? Right now we have a crushing federal debt, annual deficit, and when we at the same time a sagging economy.
Yes.
So we feel like we have competing priorities. A lot of people say that when we reduce tax rates, we're compounding the problem of the debt because we're reducing government revenues.
No.
And you respond?
Four times in American history, Coolidge, Kennedy, Reagan, Bush, we have cut taxes across the board, and that includes on the rich, and four times revenues have gone up and the rich have paid more. Now, during three of those times, we also spent more. So the total deficits got bigger, but the revenue coming in got larger and the rich paid more and the poor and middle class paid less. This is not in any of my books, and I had it in What Would the Founder Say, and I was really right. proud of this, but they didn't use it. But envision a triangle in which you have government, the size of government at one side, taxes on the other side, and liberty down here. Mm-hmm. And as you expand that, the amount of liberty available to people decreases, the taxes go up, the role of government goes up. As you
right.
contract that, the amount of liberty available for people goes up, taxes go down, government goes down. They are all related. You can't separate revenues from the deficit. You've got to cut taxes in order to cut the deficit.
And I mean, I think that we're beginning to have a paradigm shift that way, saying that the debt is a spending side issue, that we have unsustainable spending patterns. Now, Paul Krugman would argue that while Reagan raised revenues, that was after he raised taxes in 1983.
No, wrong. And I'll show you a chart today. Tax revenue started right at 83 after the first. What caused the taxes, the tax cuts to produce revenue, is that they were staged 10%, 10%, 5%. And as Art Laffer used to say, would you go buy a refrigerator today that you know is going to be on sale 10% off tomorrow? The great input of the revenue comes after the third increment of the tax cuts.
Fascinating. And then, of course, you mentioned that there was actually a shift of the tax burden more toward higher income taxpayers. And I believe the same thing happened after the Bush tax cuts in 2001
and after Coolidge and after Kennedy. It always moves the burden toward the rich. Now, you know, some students go, well, that doesn't sound right. And I go, yeah, you know, you're right. It doesn't sound right. How many of you students here in Ohio drive on ice? Oh, yeah, we drive on ice all the time. When you get into a skid, how do you turn? Well, into the skid. That don't sound right, does it? No. But if you want to live, turn into the skid. If you want the rich to pay more, cut taxes on the rich.
Fantastic to hear. Now, what do you think would be the top thing for students to do to be activists about this cause? If they read your book, if they pick this up somewhere, if they have their textbook that's People's History of the United States or something that doesn't necessarily embrace these same values, what should they do to convey those ideas to their peers?
Well, a student is in a difficult position. A student's in a position of subservience to the
right.
professor. You're depending on the professor for a grade. I always tell students, what are your priorities? Ask yourself what your priorities are. If your priority is, I need this class, I've got to get the grade, shut up. Give him the answer he wants. Get out. And as soon as you get your grade, you go back and say, I lied about everything. I was lying about it all. And I don't believe a word you said, but thanks for the grade. If you are secure enough in yourself and you say, you know, I can suffer a C or a D in this class, stand up and fight. But never fight without sources. And this isn't your source. These are your sources.
It is meticulously researched. Buck.
The end notes are the sources for anything. We give you the sources to go to, and we used a lot of liberal sources in writing this specifically so people could go to.
Well, as a college student who's just finished my freshman year, I can appreciate that and look forward to diving into it more. Dr. Schweikart, thank you for sitting down with us.
Thank
I appreciate
you.
It.
Great interview.